Hello, this is the Provoked Prawn, and in this video I want to talk to you about how to set up the SteelSeries Arctis Nova Pro, the wired version, for streaming and recording. This is a tips video essentially to talk you through the various steps of how you can use this headset to create a really good audio for your streaming using the microphone and using settings for Discord, chat on Windows, and game audio to create multiple different audio tracks with adjustable levels and customizable sound to create a really good experience. So stick with me now as I show you the various steps for that. So I want to demonstrate a few different things that you can do to set up your SteelSeries headset for streaming purposes, and there are a number of different things to bear in mind here. The first of which is to download SteelSeries GG and make sure that you have Sonar set up. This will give you access to game and chat sounds as well as your microphone as selectable things within Windows sound settings. This also means that you can use the chat mix style to change between having lots of game audio and lots of Discord audio, for example. And this is obviously the setup for Windows, but what you need to do is make sure you have these things set up beforehand. Then in your Windows sound settings, you want to ensure that you're selecting the right things. So you can see that I have SteelSeries Sonar Gaming, for example, set as my output. And as my microphone, I have SteelSeries Sonar Microphone. And that means those are both running through those sound sources, and I can customize the audio that I'm getting through there. You'll notice that you also have SteelSeries Sonar Chat as an option here in the output, and that is the next important point. So if you open up your Discord, click on the cog icon down the bottom, go into voice and video settings, and make sure in your input device that you have SteelSeries Sonar Microphone selected, not this one, the microphone Arctis Nova Pro, because that's the default. We want to use Sonar because it gives us a better sound setting there. And then, more importantly, make sure that you have SteelSeries Sonar Chat set up as this option. Not gaming, make sure you select chat. There's a chat there. And the reason for that is that then ensures that when you're talking to your friends, it's going through the chat sound. So it's coming out into this headphone chat setup here. Now, there are a number of tweaks that you can make to the sound settings. You probably already know about the configuration for the various different game settings. But the important point here is that a couple of things of interest. First of all, if your friends have terrible audio on their microphones, you can use this chat setting to eliminate some of that. So you can use the ClearCast AI noise cancellation option here. Turn that on, for example. That'll eliminate a lot of their noise. But you can also make them sound better by selecting broadcast or clarity, for example, from the default configurations. And you can play around with the noise gate settings and smart voice settings and other things to try and improve the quality of their sound. It's great if your friends have a really cheap microphone or not a good headset and the audio is terrible. I'd also recommend going into your own microphone settings, turning on ClearCast AI noise cancellation, playing around with the settings a bit there and choosing a configuration that works well for you. Once that's all set up, we're then going to go into Streamlabs, and you can do the same thing in OBS Studio as well. Go into the little cog icon down the bottom, go into the audio settings, and we're going to choose different audio devices in here. So we're going to select the first one, which is to find the gaming audio level. So you can see that's now put on the mixer there. And then the second one is the chat. This means that Discord chat is then coming through into this channel. We'll then choose our microphone as the SteelSeries Sonar microphone virtual audio device here. So that means that all the audio sound that you've applied to these will then come through. And you should see these as different devices on here. So now we have three different audio levels set up for these different ones, and you'll see obviously we have this gaming one as the sound on there, and we have chat. So basically what's going to happen is your game audio is going to go into one channel, your microphone is going to go into another, and then the chat sound from Discord is going to go into the third one. This means that you can essentially have three different audio levels, and you can tweak this so you can choose the amount of audio that's going into this and then coming out into the stream. If you're streaming, you'll find that you have one single audio track that you're choosing on here, and that is the audio that everything is getting mixed into. Now, if you go into the mixer icon here, you can see that we can choose to select what we're putting out there. So essentially what we want to do is to make sure that the three things that we've selected are all getting picked up. So SteelSeries Sonar Chat, the microphone and the gaming audio are all being picked up and fed through into the stream. That's the streaming. Then you have the recording options. So you can actually choose which tracks are being recorded. And this is important as well, because if you're creating content, it essentially allows you to choose a number of different audio tracks. What we're going to do now for recording purposes is we're going to set up four different audio tracks. And there's a logic for this, because once you've done it for recording, what you can do is you can see that I've already got 1, 2, and 3 selected, three different SteelSeries options here and what we're going to use. Well, what we can also do is we can set up the other ones for a different use. So, for example, we can have track 2 will be gaming, track 3 will be our microphone, and track 4 will be our chat sounds. What this allows you to do is to record four different audio tracks with your video. So if you're capturing clips while you're playing games, you'll then have multiple different audio tracks in here, and they will be clean sound. So your usual output for streaming purposes will be everything mixed into one. Your gaming, your microphone and your chat. This is great if you're talking to your friends and you've got some banter going and you've got a good bit of gameplay going on and it's funny and it's amusing, whatever else. But if you find that you have a funny gameplay moment happening and your friends are talking over it, that's really annoying for clip reasons, you might want to be able to delete that. Well, what you can do once you go into the editing process for your tracks is that you'll have that clip as a sound clip with just the gaming. You could also keep two tracks together and have your game sounds and your microphone, but not your friend's audio. So this option for having three different tracks is fantastic for doing things like that. It makes it a lot easier when you then go into the editing process and customizing those. Here I am with an example track recorded in DaVinci Resolve. I've dragged this track in. As you can see, there are four audio tracks. So one of them's blank because I didn't have anybody in Discord at the time. The top one, audio track one, is everything mixed together. So that's both my mic and audio from the game and chat if anyone was using it, and that's in here at this point. So on audio track one, audio track two is just the game sound, and audio track three is my microphone sound, and then audio track four is the chat sound. So essentially what I can do is, obviously, I can mute the top one so that I only have the game and my mic. And then if I decide I don't want my mic for some reason, I just want the game audio. Now I've got just the game audio, and you could do the opposite. So if I wanted to ditch out the game audio and just keep my microphone for some reason. And so you have the option to easily record all your audio and put it into one thing. So this makes SteelSeries headset really powerful, because you then basically customize the audio levels when you're editing clips. And obviously also on the fly, you can change these things and you can tweak them within OBS or Streamlabs as well. So you can get a really great sound for your streaming and for your gameplay clips with ease. Hopefully you found this video useful. It's worth noting that you can use a 3.5mm connection line out to a streaming PC to do some other interesting things. I've been focusing here on a single PC setup, and hopefully I've given you some interesting insights into how to do it and the things that you can do. Be sure to check out the review to find out more about this headset. If you don't know already, there's a lot of things going on here. And let me know in the comments if you've got any questions, or if there's anything you'd like to know, or if you think others should know. Thanks for watching. Check out my Discord, say hello, and also a big shout out to my YouTube members who support the channel and help me create this sort of content. Thanks for watching. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Hope you found this video useful, interesting, hilarious, or otherwise. Take a look at these other videos that I think you might find interesting as well. And have a look at the description for links and other information you might find useful. Click that join button to see the benefits of being a member of my YouTube channel. And most importantly, have a great life.